Should someone have asked him, Mr. Kanye West, what do you mean by slavery being a choice?
Yes, but I wouldn't ask Mr. Kanye West that.
He said it.
That's why I say we need a code, for the simple reason he's made a statement, and that's clear enough to me that it is a choice, and that's his opinion. And if anybody asks me, now here's where the white supremacists always get black people to fall for this trick. I want to emphasize this.
Okay.
I'm thinking about it during the break. This is real serious. As victims of racism, we should have learned by now the white supremacist trick of sticking a mic in front of a black person's face and saying, say something, all right? And the black person will say something like, maybe, racism doesn't exist. And then all the other black people throughout the world, I mean, go ballistic and start saying, did that black person say that, that racism doesn't exist? And I'm putting up with racism every day? Oh, I mean, you know, I'm, and then they start cursing and you know, and just going off and criticizing the person. The code says BGQ. That's why I invented that term. Victims Guaranteed Qualification. A victim of racism can say anything. I don't care what it is. You're qualified to say it. Anything about your victimization, or even if you see your victimization as not being victimized. As a prisoner of war, you can say anything you want to about your prison situation. All prisoners are equal. And all black people are prisoners of the war between those who believe in white supremacy and those who don't. We are born in captivity. So, if a black person walks around in the prison yard saying, I'm not in prison, all right, y'all, the rest of y'all can think you're all in prison, but I'm not in prison. Well, he or she is entitled to say that.
Mm-hmm.
But the condition is still the same. Now, here's where the white supremacists trick us. They will stick a mic in front of that person's face and say, what's that you said? Said, oh, I'm not in prison. Or black people are not being mistreated, never have been mistreated. Black people have never been slaves. Black people are not slaves now. All right, some black person somewhere on the planet might say that. Okay, and then here's where the white supremacists trick us. They immediately say, did you hear what he just said? This black person said slavery is a good thing, you know, or racism doesn't exist.
Mm-hmm.
Did you hear that? And then they'll put the mic in front of another black person's mouth.
Okay.
That's where we make our mistake.
Okay.
I mean, because we don't know what to say when that happens. But the code says, I know what to say.
Oh.
I would say, yeah, I heard him say that.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. I heard him say that. Slavery doesn't exist. Slavery is a good thing. I mean, if it does exist, black people should be slaves. I heard that black person say that. But you know what? And when that white person asked me, well, what do I have to say about it? I say, he said what he said.
Okay.
She said what she said. And then, here's where I go on the offense. I say, now, I just heard what he said, sir. Or I just heard what he said, ma'am, in case it's a white woman. Then I will say, but what I am interested in, sir or ma'am, is what you have to say. Because what you have to say is a whole lot more important than what any black person that ever breathed ever says about anything. I'm saying black people have to get out of that you're a member of my gang mentality. Mr. Kanye West says what he wants to say, and you should say that he should say what he wants to say. You should be the defender of anything that he says. But let everybody know that's him talking. But what I want to know is not what Mr. Kanye West says about his condition. He can say anything he wants to about his condition. He has earned that. He has earned that.
Mm-hmm.
All right? What I want to know is, when a white person asks Mr. West, and it's just white people, who, it's a lot of white people making remarks about what Mr. West says, I want to know what those white people say about whether slavery was a choice. See what I mean? You immediately turn to the white person who is saying, did you hear what he said? Say, yeah, I heard what he said, but sir, you're white. I want to know what you got to say about slavery.
And why do you want to know that?
Because it's more important about what a white person says about slavery than it is about what any black person ever says about slavery.
What makes it more important?
Because the white person has the power.
Okay.
The black person is just talking to another, you know, black people talk all the time. We talk about everything. You know, why should anybody pay any attention to us and we're a bunch of prisoners of war? See what I mean? We pay too much, we get excited and bent out of shape about something that another black person says about anything in the system of white supremacy. And the white supremacist knows from experience that in the system of white supremacy, what any black person ever says about anything doesn't mean anything in the system of white supremacy.
Okay.
And we have to understand that. Anything that Neely Fuller says, they don't pay any attention to me, the white supremacists, except when they can get some other black person to go after Neely Fuller about something that he said.
Uh-huh.
Then it means something to the white supremacists. But the white supremacists say, those black people can get down there in the prison yard and argue all day long. That's what I want them to do. Go at each other about who is the biggest Negro and the littlest Negro in the prison. That's what we are good at. We are good at going at each other.
Okay.
About any little thing that comes up.
Yes, sir.
And the white supremacists just sit back and say, doesn't make any difference whether they agree with each other or not. I'm the boss.
Yeah, I'm running this show.
Yeah, I'm running the whole show anyway, so I don't care what them black people do down there in the prison yard. Mm-hmm.